In this video, I explain components of nuclear reactor. First, we understand what is the nuclear reactors, and then after we understand all the components of the nuclear reactors in the The nuclear reactor may be regarded as a substitute for the boiler firebox of a coal-fired steam power plant or combustion chamber of a gas turbine power plant. So we know that in a steam power plant, we use the boiler to convert the water into the steam, and in the boiler there is a combustion of fuel is carried out. Okay, same way in a gas turbine power plant, we use the combustion chamber to heat the air or a gas coming out from the compressor. So same way in a nuclear power plant, the nuclear reactor is used to heat the working fluid. Means working fluids may be water or a different types of gas. Okay, so in a Rankine cycles or a steam power plant, it is fixed the working fluid is the steam. In a gas turbine power plant, it is fixed that the air or gas is used as a working fluid. Okay, so in a nuclear reactor, we are able to use the steam as well as gas as a working substance. The heat produced in the nuclear reactor is by the fission process. Okay, means in a nuclear reactor, the process is carried out. It is called as the fission process. In a steam and gas turbine power plant, the heat is produced by the combustion of fuels. Means in a boiler, we burn the some fuels, and by burning of this fuel or by combustion of these fuels, the heat is released, and this heat is used to heat the working fluids. Okay. In a nuclear reactor, the fission process is carried out, and due to fission process, the heat is released, and this heat is utilized to heat the working fluids. The steam or gas may be the working fluid in a nuclear power plants, means according to the types of the nuclear power plants, the working fluid may be steams or working fluid may be gas. The other cycle of operations and the components required is the same, either as a steam plant, if the steam is generated, means suppose we generate the steam in a nuclear reactors. Okay, then other parts are same, means suppose instance of the boiler, here we put the nuclear reactors. Okay, then the steam is supplied into turbine, condenser and pump. Okay, and suppose we use the gas as a working fluids. Okay, then its other component are same as the gas turbine power plant. Means that is the compressor is there, instance of combustion chamber, that is a reactor is there, and after the reactor, the hot gas is supplied into these gas turbines, and then after it is passed from heat exchanger or directly supplied there to the exhaust. Okay. The general arrangements of nuclear reactors with principal component is shown in this figure. Now we understand the basic components by using this animation. Here you see this is the nuclear fuels. Okay, so here I mention it is the fuel rod, and this fuel rod is surrounded by the moderators, and this is called as the core of this nuclear reactor, and between this fuel the control rods are provided. Okay, and this control rod are able to move up and down. Then after this part is the reflectors, and after the reflectors that is the other part is there, it is called as the reactor vessels, and after the reactor vessels this is the biological shield are there. And from this space coolant is in, coolant means the working fluid is enters, and from this side this coolant is out. Now we understand all these component means which type of the fuel is used, which types of the moderator is used, what is the functions of all the components, that we understand in this sessions. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching more video related to power plant engineering as well as the other subject of this mechanical engineering. For power plant engineering, various link is provided in descriptions as well as in card. For other subject, I request to visit the playlist. So first component is the fuel. Nuclear reactor use fissionable material, means fissionable fuels are used, like uranium-235, Pu-239 and 92 uranium-233. Natural uranium found in the earth crust has 0.71% of 92 uranium-235. Okay, means majority 92 uranium-235 is used as a fuels, and this uranium means 92 uranium-235 is unstable एंड कैपेबल ऑफ सस्टेनेबल चेन रिएक्शन. मीन्स दीज यूरेनियम्स आर कैपेबल टू सस्टेन द चेन रिएक्शंस. द फ्यूल इज शेप इन अ वेरियस शेप लाइक रोड. हियर यू सी दीज आर इन द शेप ऑफ द रोड्स बट वी आर एबल टू पुट द फ्यूल इन अ डिफरेंट शेप. ओके सो वी आर यूज द रोड शेप प्लेट्स पैलेट टीन्स. ओके सो दीज आर द वेरियस शेप इज पॉसिबल एंड लोकेटेड इन द रिएक्टर इन सच ए मैनर दैट द हीट प्रोडक्शन विद इन द रिएक्टर इज यूनिफॉर्म्स. मीन्स दे आर अरेंज सच ए वे दैट द हीट प्रोड्यूस इज यूनिफॉर्म. मीन्स द सेम क्वांटिटी ऑफ हीट रिमूव फ्रॉम द फ्यूल एंड मीन्स इन अ रिएक्टर द यूनिफॉर्म हीट प्रोडक्शंस आर देयर. द फ्यूल एलिमेंट्स आर डिजाइंडेड taking into account the heat transfers, corrosions and the structural strains. Means this fuel element, means fuel shape is designed. At that time they are focused on the three parameters. First is the heat transfer, means the heat production. Second one is the corrosion. And the third one is the structural strain. So there is the two types of the reactor is possible. One is the heterogeneous and another is the homogeneous. Okay. So heterogeneous reactor means the fuel is used in a form of rod, plates, and moderators surround the fuel elements. So in this diagram you see that is the first fuel rod is there and the fuel rod is surrounded by the moderators. Okay, so in this diagram we see these heterogeneous reactors. Okay, and this arrangement is commonly used in the most of the reactors. Second one is the homogeneous reactors. Homogeneous means the fuel and moderators are mixed to form a uniform mixture. Means fuel and moderator are mixed, then after they are put in these reactors. So uranium and carbon, and then it is used in the form of rods and plates in the reactor core. Means uraniums and carbon are mixed, and by using them the fuel rods are created or a plates are created, and then after they are put in the reactor core. The fuel rod are clad with stainless steel, zirconiums or by aluminium to prevent oxidation of uranium. Means this fuel rod, okay, this black color portion is the fuel rod, and they are coated, clad means they are coated with the stainless steels or a zirconium or a by aluminiums to prevent the oxidations of the uraniums. Second component is the moderators. It is a material used to slow down the neutrons from high kinetic energy to slow Newton in a fraction of second. Means it is used to reduce the velocity of a Newtons. Okay, so Newton coming out from the fuel have a velocity of 13,200 kilometer per second, and it is reduced to 2200 meter per second. Okay, so here only this digit is not reduced, but here you see the unit is also reduced, that is a kilometer per second to meter per second. So it is a very big change in this velocity, and it is in the within a seconds, in a fraction of seconds. The function of moderator is to increase the probability of a reactions. Means increase the probability of chain reactions. The fission chain reaction in the nuclear reactor is maintained due to the slow Newtons when the ordinary uranium is used as a fuel. Means when we use the ordinary uranium as a fuels, okay, at that time this chain reaction is continued due to the slow speed of the Newtons. Okay, that's why the slow speed of the Newton is important. Okay, if suppose the high speed of the Newton is there, then the chain reactions are not maintained. Okay, so for maintaining these chain reactions we need to reduce the Newton speed, and Newton speed is reduced by using these moderators. The moderators are lighter than fuel. Various material used for moderators are, first is the ordinary waters, means H2O. Second one is the deuteriums or a heavy water, it is denoted as D2O. Third one is graphites, and fourth one is the beryllium. So these are the various four substances that may be used as a moderators. The graphite, heavy water or beryllium can be used as a moderator with natural uranium. Means When we use the natural uranium as a fuel, at that time we have a three option, or a, we have a three options of material for the moderators. First one is graphites, heavy waters and beryllium. The ordinary water means it is a simple water that we drink, that is the H2O, is used as a moderator only with the enriched uranium. Okay, so when we use the enriched uranium as a fuels, at that time we are able to use the ordinary water as a moderators. As a moderators, D2O means heavy water, is the base materials having a moderating ratio of 12,000 as compared to 72 for H2O or 170 for the carbon. Means this is the value of moderating ratio. Okay, so that is the, this D2O means heavy water are the base moderators. The following are the desirable properties of a good moderators. First is the moderator must be as light as possible. The slowing down action is more effective in elastic collisions with the light elements. Means it is light in weight, then they are very efficient or they are very effective. It must not absorb neutrons during the slowing down them. Means when these moderators are reduced the speed of the neutrons, at that time they are not able to absorb the neutrons. Okay, they are just reduce the speed, they are just reduce the velocity of the neutrons, but must not absorb the neutrons. It must be able to work under high pressures, high temperature with good corrosion resistance. Means at the high pressure and high temperatures they are good corrosion resistance. It must have high chemical stability, as well as it should not be decomposed due to the nuclear radiation. Means they are not react with some chemicals, means they are come in the contact with the fuels, they are come with the contact with the coolant. Okay, at that time they are chemically stable, they are not change this chemical formula. It is called as the chemical stabilities. Now the third component is the control rods. So in this diagram here you see these control rods are putted between these different fuel rods. Okay, so what is the functions of the control rod? Why these control rods are required in these nuclear reactors? The control system control the rate of energy generated. So from the name we can understand control rods means they are control the rate of energy generated. Means when we move this control rod up and down, we can start the chain reactions, we can increase the chain reaction, we can reduce the chain reaction, or even we can stop the chain reaction. That's why its name is given the control rod. So what they control? They control the rate of energy generated. Means it start, increase, decrease and stop the chain reactions. That's why its name is given the control rods. These rods may be shaped like the fuel rods themselves and are interspread throughout this reactor core. Now what is the reactor core? This combination of the moderators and the fuel rods, it is called as the reactor cores. Okay, and here you see it is the fuel rods are inserted in a reactor core. Means they are move up and down in this reactor core. Means when we fully remove that, at that time this speed of the chain reaction are higher. When these control rods are moved down, means they are inserts in a reactor core, at that time these chain reactions are stop. Instance of containing fuel, they contain neutron absorbers such as the boron, cadmiums and indiums. Means these are the material used as a control rod. They have high neutron absorption cross section, means they are absorbs the neutrons, that's why they are able to control the chain reactions. The control is necessary to prevent the melting of fuel rods, disintegrations of coolant and destructions of the reactor, as the amount of energy release is erroneous. Okay, means this control of the chain reactions are very important to avoid this melting of fuels, disintegration of the coolants, and that are other reasons. The control rod can be moved in and out of the reactor's core assembly either automatically or manually. Means this control rods are move up and down. Here we draw already the arrow. So these moving process are either manually or either automatically. Means they are operated by using this robot, or they are operated by humans. The magnitude of insertion of control rod represent the proposed net absorption of newtons. Means we insert this control rod in a reactor core, then these reactions are stops. Okay. When we remove from this reactor core, then the chain reaction is start or they are increase. Now fourth component is the coolant. We can also say it is the working substance of the nuclear power plants. So from the name we can understand what is the functions of the coolant. Coolant is absorb the heat from the nuclear fuels. So main purpose of the coolant in the reactor is to transfer the heat produced in the reactor and keep the fuel assembly at a safe temperatures to avoid their melting and destructions. Means when we pass the coolant and the suppose we consider this is the working fluids. Okay. So suppose we supply these ordinary waters, then water is absorb this heat energy from the fuel and the fuel temperature is reduced and this water is converted into the steam. Okay, so here from this place this coolant is out, means suppose the steam is coming out, then steam is supplied to the turbines or there is a one heat exchanger is put in between. Okay, that is a different possibilities are that according to these types. The same heat carry by the coolant is used in the heat exchanger for further utilizations in the power generations, either generating steams or using the hot gas. Means we can supply this gas, then the gas temperature is increased. Suppose we supply this water, then it is converted in steam. Then after one heat exchanger is put in, and from this heat exchanger, from the other pipes, the water is entered and this water is converted into the steam. Means for the safety purpose, to avoid these radiations, we can put this one more heat exchangers. The coolant used should have high specific heat to reduce its mass flow rate. Means suppose we require the less mass flow rate, then we can use the material which have a high specific heat. Means high specific heat coolant are able to absorb the more heat. Okay, and they absorb the more heat, then they are convert into the steams, or they absorb the more heat means its temperature are more increased. It shall not absorb newtons and it must be non-corrosive, non-toxic, non-oxidizing with high chemical stability. Means coolant not absorb newtons. Okay, means we need to use such a types of the coolant, they are not absorb the newtons. Okay, they are non-corrosive, non-toxic, non-oxidizing with high chemical stabilities. Now what are the various material used as a coolant? First one is the water, heavy waters. So these are the liquids. Suppose we can use the gas. As a gas we can use the heliums or a CO2, means carbon dioxide. Another are the sodiums in a liquid form, and organic liquid are used as a coolant. So these are the very important components. Then after that is a, here you see these three components are used as a walls for the different purpose. This is the reflectors, reactor vessels and biological cells. For the word you can already understand, reflector are used to reflect the newtons. Okay, so it is important to conserve the newton as much as possible for reducing consumption of fissible materials and keep the size of the reactor small. Means they are used to reflect the newtons, and by these reflectors we can reduce the size of the reactors. So this is possible by surrounding the reactor core. What is the meaning of reactor core? Reactor core means this fuel rods, and the moderator part is called as the reactor core. So this is possible by surrounding this reactor core with a material which reflect the escaping newtons back into the core, and this material is called as the reflector. Means sometimes these newtons are escaping from the chain reactions. Okay, so these newtons are come into contact with the reflectors, and the reflector is again spend the newtons or again return these newtons into a chain reactions or in a this core of the reactors. The required properties of a good reflectors are low absorption and high reflections for the newtons, high resistance to oxidations and irradiation, as well as the high radiation स्टेबिलिटीज मीन्स रिफ्लेक्टर नॉट एब्जॉर्ब द न्यूटन्स, दे जस्ट ओनली रिफ्लेक्ट द न्यूटन्स, मीन्स हाई रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द न्यूटन्स आर रिक्वायर, देन हाई रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीडेशन इज रिक्वायर एंड ई रेडिएशन एज वेल एज द हाई रेडिएशन स्टेबिलिटीज. द मटेरियल यूज फॉर द मॉडरेटर आर ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द रिफ्लेक्टर्स लाइक एज द H2O, D2O एंड द कार्बन. इट इज नेसेसरी टू प्रोवाइड सम मैथड ऑफ कूलिंग द रिफ्लेक्टर एज इट इज गेट हीटेड ड्यू टू द कोलिजन्स ऑफ न्यूटन्स विथ इट एटम्स. सो वैन डीज न्यूटन्स आर द स्ट्राइक विद डीज रिफ्लेक्टर्स एट दैट टाइम्स दिस टेम्परेचर ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्टर्स आर इंक्रीज. सो वी नीड टू प्रोवाइड वन कूलिंग मेकेनिज्म, मीन्स कूलिंग ऑफ दिस रिफ्लेक्टर सर्फेस आर रिक्वायर. सो वी नीड टू प्रोवाइड कूलिंग ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्टर्स. नेक्स्ट कंपोनेंट इज द शील्डिंग. सो हियर यू कैन सी दैट इज द बायोलॉजिकल सील वर्ड इज मेंशन्स. ओके, सो शील्डिंग द रेडियो एक्टिव जोन इन द रिएक्टर फ्रॉम पॉसिबल रेडिएशन हैजर्डस इज एसेंशियल टू प्रोटेक्ट द ह्यूमन लाइफ फ्रॉम हार्मफुल इफेक्ट. मीन्स वी नो दैट द न्यूक्लियर मटेरियल्स आर रिमूव द वेरियस रेडिएशन, सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज द रेडियो एक्टिव मटेरियल्स. ओके, so this radioactive material is stopped by using this biological cells. So common radiations from the reactors are alpha ray, beta ray, gamma ray and the fast neutrons, and we know that these alpha ray, beta and gamma rays are harmful to our human body. To prevent the effect of these radiations on the human life, it is necessary to absorb them before emitting to the atmosphere. Means we need to absorb these radioactive materials. Okay, and for absorbing these radioactive material, that shieldings are provided, and it is called as the biological shield. And these shieldings is consist of inner lining of 50 to 60 centimeter of plate on the reactor core called as the thermal shield, with a few meter of thick concrete wall surrounding this inner seal called as the biological seal. Means these biological seals are combination of the two part. First part is the steel plates are used, that is the thickness is the 50 to 60 centimeters, and then are the concrete walls are there. The lining of steel plate absorb these energies and become heated, but prevent this adjacent wall of the reactor vessel from becoming heated. And this thermal seal is cooled by circulations of waters. Okay, thermal seals are heated and then its temperature is lowered by using the circulations of water. And the last part is the reactor vessels. The reactor vessel enclose the reactor core, means here you see at the center parts these reflectors and the reactor vessels are there. Okay, so this is the reactor vessel. So what is the functions? The reactor vessel is enclose the reactor core, reflectors and the shield. It also provides coolant inlet and outlet passage. Here you see this coolant inlet and outlet passage are there. The reactor vessel has to withstand the pressure at 200 bar or above. The reactor core means fuel, and the moderator assembly is generally placed at the bottom of the vessel. So here you see at the bottom of this vessel we are putting this reactor core. Okay, so here we complete these various components of the nuclear reactors. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels and share with your friends.